My name is Francois Thibault. I've been a resident of the Northwest Territories now for over 30 years. I came tonight to ask the old guard why, that for the past 15 years, nothing has been done to support the trade industry, mainly jewelry. Cowett seems to have had a program since, I think, 1970, 75 or something like that. Our government has literally spent millions and millions and millions of dollars to get nowhere. There's been factory after factory closed. We are the ones that are actually paying for their mistakes. And they're usually mistakes from people that live in Montreal, Israel. The employment, obviously, is not here because we need the aptitude to sit at a table and cut small bits of carbon. Like loose hair tufting, it's not everybody that wants to sit there and do that all day. But one thing is clear is that 15 years ago, when the government of the Northwest Territories hired the biggest manufacturing companies in Canada to come over here and direct the government on how to create this industry. And they all came up with the same conclusion. There's room here for a small to medium-sized manufacturing company, lots of room for mom-and-pop operations. So, considering that very few of you have actually even come over to my shop to even look at how jewelry is made, yet every one of them has a ring, or wears earrings, or wedding bands, etc. What are you planning on doing for the jewelry industry for the Northwest Territories, and why is it put on hold? And mainly, when is it going to go? Because I haven't taken 10 cents off the government as a grant. I bought all the tools. I've been patiently waiting because supposedly there's going to be a jewelry component to this diamond strategy, and it's been perfect. It's a $59 billion a year industry. That's a hell of a lot of money. So why is Iqaluit, which has a very small population, with the program, there's nothing being done here? The next question I have is, it's a statement. If we end up giving these buildings away at 20 cents on the dollar because of another flop, could we not just perhaps give it to the Aurora College or the Boy Scouts or anybody, an arts society perhaps? At 20 cents on a dollar, we should really look at what the hell we're doing with our money and not end up giving it to some guy from God knows where.
All right. I think I heard three questions and at least two statements in there. Who would you like to direct that to?
Bob McLeod, mm-hmm. And anybody else that would like to answer.
It's probably best to pick a writer.
Mr. McLeod.
And Cam Lake, and we'll leave it at that for now. Okay, go ahead, and Mr. Bob McLeod, you're on yourself.
Yeah, thank you for that question. The government has just recently approved and implemented a diamond policy framework that will see the resurrection of the diamond cutting and polishing industry, secondary industry in the Northwest Territories. We have an RFP process out. We have two buildings, and we've had substantial interest. I'm not sure what you're referencing in Nunavut or Iqaluit, when I'm not aware of them having a jewelry school. We tried to have a jewelry program through Aurora College, and that failed because there was no interest in it. The needs assessment showed there was no interest in doing so that was stopped. I fully expect that we'll have two additional factories in place within the next 6 months. Thank you for the question.
Thank you. Cam Lake, Dave Brown.
Thanks very much, Justin. Thanks for the question, Francois. I appreciate Yeah, you coming up to the mic and asking that question. I think it's very concerning that the government of the Northwest Territories, when it relates to the secondary diamond industry to date, their efforts have been a dismal failure on all fronts. There is some hope. I know my colleague, Mr. McLeod, talked about the policy framework on diamonds moving forward and the possibility that we may have cut and polish facilities back in Yellowknife. Currently, we only have the one downtown at Crossworks. I think jewelry manufacturing in the Northwest Territories should be explored, should be looked at. There's successful programs in Russia and carvers. We have a number of carvers here and they're very talented and they turn into the best jewelry makers. So I think, you know, we have the talent here. It could be an industry in and of itself, and I think we need to put the resources behind it and do it in a meaningful way so that we can train some of our young, talented artists to become jewelry makers. Thank you.
And thank you. And Brian Sutherland, Cameron.
Thank you. I think when you originally asked your question, the reason you referenced the old guard was that you wanted to know why these things haven't been done. The same things that you hear now, we've heard before, so if the pattern continues, these things, they open up and shut down. No reason to believe that success is going to come from whatever it is they're working on. And in fact, you know, I get confused a lot because our government, our consensus-style government, where everybody is the government, Dave Ramsey here is saying the government failed, but this system, he is the government, right? So if you're asking the old guard why it failed, there should be a specific answer, at least by this point, right? So there's not much I can say as to what exactly I can do to help our legislative body build the tertiary industry that they've been promising for 12 years that you haven't already heard before. You know, so you know, if the government can't say why the government.
All right, and our well-a-day riding, Bob Brown.
Thank you, Monsieur Thibault. You know, why is the jewelry manufacturing industry not happening? There is no good response to that. It should be happening. We have the artists across the Northwest Territories. We have the value of minerals. The need is clear. I have spoken to you. I've visited your shop. I know what the potential is. So we need to get going with that. I have spoken on this in the House to no avail, and I will continue to push for it. We do have a diamond polishing industry policy that has failed, although it's well-intended, and I recognize that, but I can't be a continual optimist on that. If we need to send some NWT diamonds south, have them polished, bring them back, and put into jewelry made here, that sounds to me like a really good option. So that's where I'm at on that, and I think that's a really good question. The buildings for jewelers, I think we should explore that with the existing polishing buildings and see if we can't come up with support for an industry there.
Awesome. All right, thank you. And Mark Bogan, candidate for
Wellington. Bon, Thibault, je suis pas mal désolé pourquoi ça marche pas, là. Vraiment, ça fait des années, ça a l'air. Là, je vais parler un petit peu en anglais, s'il vous plaît. What could be done is how our government might want to talk to people like you. You're the guy making it. You're the guy in the industry. As far as I'm concerned, you're an expert witness. Why they're not talking to you? Encore, Thibault, je suis désolé. C'est pas quoi te dire, tu sais. I'm a little disillusioned. So that's just really, if the government is prepared to do make good of its promises, I think a starting point, I would be speaking to people like you. Because again, you're the little guy out there trying to make a buck. And you're probably the best versed on what should be done in order to promote diamond craft within the Northwest Territories. Thank you.
Right, merci. Thank you.
Bonne question.
Thank you for the question.
Just one more comment, if I may.
Very briefly, yeah.
Those 15 people that you actually hired to come up here and advise you guys, they were all carvers, every last one of them. That's how they started their jewelry manufacturing companies. God knows we have a lot of carvers up here.
Thank you.